a 40-year-old graduate with a master's in organizational leadership and nonprofit management, owner of Masculine Company, and the proud executive director of Miss Syracuse and Miss Central New York organization, I am Joshua Michael King.
Perrin, owner and operator of The Goal Line. The Goal Line is all about pushing positivity with purpose and passion through motivational collaboration, fitness, and fashion. All about the motivational lifestyle.
Hello, I am judge number two. I am the founder of Los Milipedos, the term overlooked, strong, and empathetic, a clothing line to inspire you to get mental health and read the red flag in the domestic violence relationship.
Hello, good evening. My name is Amalia Scandalis. I am judge number three. I'm owner of Ants Farm LLC, an educational consultation and cultural business and local art teacher in Syracuse.
Hi, everybody. My name is Sergeant First Class Ruby Don Lindsay, 25-year Army veteran, retired in 6 months. Woo! Grandmother of six. God bless.
Hello, everybody. Welcome. My name is Sarah Barrows. I'm a local real estate agent and a very, very avid supporter of this organization. I'm happy to have been able to do this quite a few times. I know a couple of faces in the room, and I'm so happy to see you all. I want to wish everybody good luck, and thank you so much for coming.
My name is Sharon Owens. I'm judge number six. I'm the deputy mayor of the city of Syracuse. Amazing to be here and to meet all these amazing young women. And I'm a first timer, but I hope not to be a last timer. This is great.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Julie Cecil. I'm an Adirondack County Family Court judge. I am the first timer on this, too. So I am your judge number seven. How about that?
Say hi to the kids.
Hello, everyone. I'm Lakeisa Renee, co-host and board member of the competition tonight. So happy to see you all here. Are you enjoying yourself so far? Yes, I'm so glad to hear that. Yeah, so we got some talent coming up next that's going to blow your minds. We got a preview last night, and I feel sorry for the judges because it's going to be a hard. Yes. All right, so first up, we're going to have candidate number one, Serena.
I get up, I get down, and I'm jumping around. And the rump is a rug, it's a comfortable nap. Been a hell of a ride, but I'm thinking it's time to grow.
Metronome.
Man, I'm up to something. Ooty-la-dee-da, thank you all for coming. I hope you like the show, cause it's on a budget. So ooty-la-dee-da, yeah, come on, here we go, yeah. Come on.
Here we go.
Yourself through art, and it's a form of beauty that we can use to express in my culture. And not having therapy, this is a way that I just express myself, you know, in my, for my culture. And I'm gonna be drawing a flower. other females in my culture to for beauty, just to, we don't have many outlets, and this is a form of an outlet while expressing it using beauty. This is my henna design. I drew a flower because it is something that describes my philosophy of life. You grow through what you go through, and this is my quick artwork. It's a flower.
Wow.
Zala, candidate number three for talent.
Take time.
Thank you. Let's say hi to some important people.
Thank you.
I think I see one. Everybody, this is Kaya.
Hello, Kaya. You look beautiful.
She says she's too scared. She didn't get enough time at the Academy of Excellence. Because now she's back at regular school. But that's all right, right? You like it there?
Yes.
What do you love most about school?
I love reading because I really love reading
in
the big library.
Yes. What school do you go to?
Syracuse Latin.
Is that a private school?
No.
No, it's one of the many amazing schools we have here in Syracuse, right?
Yes.
Awesome. Well, Kaya, thank you for coming. I love your tiara. Do you see all the crowns up there? How many do you see?
Three.
Three? Interesting. Thank you, Kaya.
We wonder why. It's a surprise.
It takes a lot of effort being this small. It's okay to laugh at me because if Elle Woods was legally blonde, I am legally small. And don't even get me started about going on roller coasters. Every time I get to the front of the line, I always have to face that sit. You could give me one good look, and you know I don't stand a chance. Now, does anyone know the height requirement you should be for your sun visor and your car to actually work? Well, I'll take that laugh as a no. But I can definitely tell you it is not 411. And you can ask the divider I hit on the first day of driving. Well, being this small does have some perks. I can save money by buying some clothes in the kids section. I have a lot of people to quite literally look up to. And my friends consider me travel-sized. But at the end of the day, we all have things that make us different and unique. But we must learn to love ourselves for who we are. I might be small. But you guys are looking at the queen of eating free meals at Owens. Thank you.
How's everybody doing?
We're doing all right there. How are you doing up there?
Pretty good. I'm a little deaf because of the bagpipes. We gotta turn it up.
Okay. Well, I hope you can find your way back down. I don't know who permissed you to get up there.
Yeah, I ain't get to see you now.
Wow. That girl is gutsy. All right. Thank you.
that we can take together. We can make a change.
Lexi.
Senator Rachel May, go ahead and stand up for everybody and come on over here.
Left my tiara at home, unfortunately. I'm very happy to be here and excited to see the incredible talent we've got out here. I just, every time I go to something, it makes me so proud of my community. And these young women are astounding. So anyway, what I have is a proclamation celebrating 100 years of Miss Syracuse and Miss Central New York, the scholarship competition. In the New York State Senate, we like to honor organizations that have made a substantial impact on the quality of life in their communities. And that is why I'm proud to make this proclamation on behalf of the New York State Senate to celebrate 100 years of Miss Syracuse and Miss Central New York scholarship competition's involvement with the Miss America pageant. And I want to read you a few things about the history. The first woman to be crowned Miss Syracuse in 1922 was Rosamund Fahey. Syracuse made history again in 1984 when Vanessa Williams was crowned the first Black Miss America. And again in 2014, when Nina Davuluri of Fayetteville was the first woman of Indian descent to be crowned Miss America. So this proclamation goes on, whereas the Miss Syracuse and Miss Central New York Scholarship Organization provide an exceptional platform for young women to have access, visibility, resources, and inclusion in opportunities to be awarded funding for education, experiential entrepreneurship, and career advancement. And whereas 100 years after Rosamund Fahey made history as the first Miss Syracuse, the Miss Syracuse and Miss Central New York Scholarship Competition is returning and rebuilding its legacy in Syracuse, which is full of talented and influential women who can become role models for young people.
Many of you.
Sitting right here in the front today. And this represents an opportunity for Syracuse and Central New York to be realigned with the advancing mission of the Miss America organization and showcase talented women who enrich their communities. The jobs of Miss Syracuse and Miss Central New York provide an exciting, fun, and challenging once-in-a-lifetime year of service in which honorees promote the program to their peers and the next generation of young women and serve others above themselves. So now, therefore, be it proclaimed that I, New York State Senator Rachel May, join in celebrating 100 years of the Miss Syracuse and Miss Central New York Scholarship Competition's involvement with the Miss America pageant. Yes.
Thank you for all that you do for our state and our city and our county. Rachel May, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, come on, Sparkle. Come on and step on in. Press on in.
I just have to say, I'm Alisa Whitfield. I'm the president of the New York Miss America organization, and Mac is here somewhere. He went to take a little break, so he's going to be so mad that he's not seeing the suit right now. But I just wanted to say congratulations. We are so excited to have Syracuse back.
Let's go.
Oh my goodness. We are so, so excited. And let me tell you, you have come out and made it with a bang. So thank you. Thank you so much for both of you for doing this and really taking hold of it, getting your sponsors, amazing judges. You have the deputy mayor, you got the senator. What is going on up in Syracuse?
So much for coming.
You're gonna rock it. Thank you.
We'll see you at New York for sure. Because I'm fairly convinced, like I was that time, that I was the one who was responsible for Nia Franklin, Miss America. Who knows Nia Franklin? We know Nia Franklin. Yeah, I was that guy who was sitting in that row right there. And there's another one too. So I'm fairly confident today, and we've been talking about this a lot. So like being that I'm the executive director and board members, we can talk about this stuff, but our boards, we feel sorry for y'all to have to really be the ones to make this decision. Very, very convinced that the next Miss New York is in this room tonight. No. The next Miss New York is in this room tonight.
And we're about to do on-stage questions and pitches from our candidates. Are you ready? All right. First up, candidate number one, Serena. How do you plan to use your aspiring law degree to make a positive impact in and out of your community? And what is your time frame for attaining this goal?
Absolutely, that's a great question. The law field is very important. You know, a lot of people do not know what the laws are in their area, and because of that, people get taken advantage of. So by being a lawyer, I'm able to help underprivileged communities so that they can be educated on the laws around them so they can get the legal assistance that they need. And I have a 5-year plan for this, and that includes competing in this organization so I can afford to go to grad school and attain that degree. Thank you.
Candidate number one, Serena.
Suicide is now the second leading cause of death for all young people under the age of 34. In order to fight against this, we need to have more open and honest conversations about mental health. We must educate ourselves on the signs and symptoms of depression and anxiety. But most importantly, we must check in with ourselves and our mental well-being. I'm working to educate young people with the ability to recognize and regulate their emotions, which diminishes the suicide rate so we can address mental illness early on. So join me in my fight to take mental health action to cultivate suicide prevention. Thank you.
How has your religion affected your ability to stick to what your goal is for your community?
Hello. I honestly would not say my religion has affected it. It's more of a cultural factor because they don't believe that usually women do not have a voice in our community, and this is like this sort of taboo for a woman to speak up on something that she believes in, where we should just be in, basically in the house and not speaking on anything we believe in, while the man is more into the political aspects of our lives.
Thank you.
As a black refugee woman who comes from a Somali Bantu minority ethnic group, I have grown up around a culture where mental health issues is either silenced, not accepted, or avoided. Due to either there being social, cultural stigmas, lack of awareness, or just lack of resources, a lot of us aren't able to deal with our mental health challenges. I am currently working with Layla's of a campaign that helps black women with empowerment and fighting different stigmas in different areas. I am looking to start a platform where I can ensure that the minority communities will be seen, heard, and have the help that access to the help they need when it comes to fighting mental health challenges.
Candidate number three, Shana Reed.
All right, your question is, how would you create a sustainable community funding network for children and families?
That's a great question. It starts with asking a question and reaching out to organizations who have the funding. That's it. Ask the question.
Thank you.
Oh, it's my turn. Art heals. That is why I'm collaborating with organizations and partnerships to bring arts and wellness programming to underrepresented communities. 2 years ago, my life changed when I was diagnosed with Bell's palsy, and while I was struggling through that, I also cared for my Nana until she died. It took a toll on my health, and I decided to delve deeper into my arts practice to open up my reservoir of healing. Let's tap into our creative selves so we can live, love, and be. Will you live lab with me? Thank you.
Thank you so much, Donna.
Donna
Reed. All right now, madam. They switching up on me. That's not what you just had on. All right. This question comes from Sergeant First Class Ruby Dawn Price. She would like to know, what's the first thing you will push if you win tonight?
The first thing I would push is the importance of my social impact initiative. We all age, we all grow as individuals, and my impact initiative strives so that we have a quality of life as we go through this journey and our purpose. For me, that means going into the schools, going into the community of Central New York, and pushing what it means to be financially literate, what it means to take care of yourself and make better decisions so that you age with dignity and you're able to do those tasks, you're able to feel better, and you're able to prevent chronic illnesses that are preventable. And ultimately also supporting the Central New York community through showing up and showing out, going to the events, promoting the businesses, and showing that this organization is not just here to serve the Miss New York, it's here to serve Central New York in all facets. Thank you. It's time for a culture change. I began this discussion through my social media, reaching hundreds of thousands of followers and also individuals through outreach. I started my nonprofit organization and also wrote my first book. My My goal is financial literacy, education on health for longevity, and in return, interpersonal confidence. My strive is that all Americans have access to equal quality of life. It's time to invest in yourselves, your health, and your wealth. Thank you.
Thank you, number four, Victoria.
And number five, Rachel.
All right, Rachel, your question is from Sarah Barrows, and your question is, you spoke about your concert raising money for autism and mentioned housing. How is housing an issue for autistic people or people with other disabilities, and how is your platform going to address that issue?
Well, housing is a huge issue for autistic people and people with other disabilities because we are cheated out of opportunities for housing, insurance, and so many other things. They look at us like we're second-class citizens, and they deny us the opportunity for housing, and so many of us every day are left out on the street. And my nonprofit, Ability Beyond Disabilities, is constantly working to change that, to make sure that autistic people and every disabled person is going to get the opportunity for a chance at life, a home, and basic human rights. We don't grow when things are easy. We grow when we face challenges. At the age of 3, I was diagnosed with autism. Doctors told my parents that I would never accomplish anything, yet here I am proving them wrong every single day. As Miss Central New York, it's okay. All right. As Miss Central New York, I will continue to create limitless possibilities for autistic people with all the organizations I'm working with throughout the New York area and prove that we have abilities beyond our disabilities.
Thank you so much, Rachel. Number 6, Julia Walsh. This question comes from the Deputy Mayor, Sharon Owen. She would like to know, tricky. New York State standardized tests are delivered in written form. This can be a huge disadvantage for students with dyslexia. How would you use this platform to address this issue with state lawmakers like Senator Rachel May?
To be totally honest, I don't think that dyslexic students should be forced to take standardized tests. I know for myself, I always had testing anxiety, especially when it came to those, so I will definitely fight for dyslexic students everywhere so they can get equal opportunity and be successful in their schools. This might surprise you, but 80% of New York's prison population show signs of dyslexia. And a quarter of all CEOs actually have dyslexia. These statistics are proof that dyslexics can be successful if they are diagnosed early and given the resources they need. I'm asking for this job because I have a plan for early diagnosis and I know it's going to work. So let's decide to prioritize dyslexia today.
Thank you so much, Julia. Ashley, your question is from Julie. Social media has had a significant negative impact on youth. How would you specifically address social media and promote your projects, semicolon?
I would start off by saying that not everything on social media is as it seems. As someone who is addicted to social media, just a little bit, I believe that you need to focus on seeing those people that are showing their true selves, not just them. And through my social impact initiative, I will make sure that people understand that, hey, I'm standing here right now with anxiety. I suffered through depression. I almost took my life 5 years ago, and that is okay. I'm human. I go through struggles, and every human is different and unique in their own way. So being awarded with Miss Central New York tonight would really give me a platform to show that it is okay not to be okay. Have suffered
murders are on the rise and the pandemic has only made it more challenging. It is time to start the conversation about mental health, educate the public on how to help those who are suffering. Be vulnerable and show that your mental health does not define who you are. As a community leader and partner with Project Semicolon, I am ready to show you that your story is not over. Thank you.
Number 8, Clara. All right, this question comes from Nina Perrin. She would like to know, in regard to short-term goals, what is the first plan of action if you won today, and how do you plan to measure that success?
My first plan of action is to get the word out about water quality protection. I would go on all of my social media as Miss Syracuse, Miss Central New York, and talk about our water quality in Syracuse, New York. I would measure that success by how many people I reach over social media on TikTok, Instagram, or Facebook, and how many people engage with it and show action in their own lives. Thank you. We all have cherished memories of our favorite times spent outside, often around water. With only 1.2% of all water on the planet available for drinking and 7 billion people who need to share it, we have to take better care of our water sources. From puddle to planet and every environment in between, we need to be aware of how both pollution and invasive species affect our water quality and our livelihoods. I work with the New York State Department of Environmental Conservation to remove invasive species and to challenge our youth to become champions of the environment. Thank you.
Next up, we have candidate number 9, Scarlett.
All right, your question is from Angela. How will your political knowledge help? Sorry, start that over. I couldn't read it. How will your political knowledge help our low-income community, and what is your plan to help?
I grew up in a low-income household. My mother made $9,000 a year, so I understand the struggles, and currently there are no policies in place that are lifting people out of poverty and into the middle class or higher. With my knowledge of political science, I have been able to go to low-income students and help them receive an education, whether it be through paying for FAFSA applications or Common App applications or anything like that. The point is, with an education, you can get out of poverty. And by showing that to these young individuals and even older individuals, anybody can get out of poverty, and all you need is a little bit of knowledge. Throughout my life, I've talked politics with 90% of the people I've met. No, really, seriously. But unfortunately, each time, most people fear the inevitable arguments or confrontation. That's why I created Politics for the People, a movement reclaiming the political realm for all Americans. Through teaching an unbiased education, positive politics, and legislation, people can be comfortable with politics. It's time to talk about what impacts us most and get political.
Thank you, Scarlett. Lexi. Lexi, your question comes from Amalia Scandow. She'd like to know, how will you partner with other religious institutions to ensure that inclusion to all families is equitable?
So actually, this is a wonderful topic when it comes to religion and inspiring people and our youth. Currently, there's a society called the Society of National Religion. They are a worldwide program that combines churches of other religions, Muslim, Catholic, Free Methodist, Methodist, any form of religion that you can possibly think of, and you combine your ideas to support your community. It's not about the religion, it is about the people you are helping, and there's already a program in place, so we just need to ask a question, reach out to that program, and involve ourselves right here in Syracuse, New York. The nefarious cycle of
neglect, abandonment, and abuse in the lives of children across our nation has led to a 68% increase in the risk of substance abuse, homelessness, depression, anxiety, and so many other severe mental health issues. For just over 15,000 students across New York State, this cycle could become their haunting reality unless we, as a community, do something to break it. If we want to see the world change, and we want to see Syracuse, New York change right around us, we need to start with the children, because they are young and they are resilient. My question is for you. Will you spread love? Will you spread kindness? And will you make moments matter for all of the children here in Central New York?
Thank you so much, Lexi.
And we have candidate 11, Lillian. And your question is from Sergeant Ruby Dawn Price. If you win, what platform of yours do you push first in your agenda?
The platform I push first is equality in our volunteer fire departments. Less than 5% of female firefighters across the country are struggling to make a difference in the stereotypes that we have about male-dominated departments. I'm going to make a difference if being Miss Syracuse or Central New York, and I hope you will be on that journey with me. Thank you. Over the last 2 years, our world has been turned upside down. We have been not have many people, Over the last 2 years, we don't have many people working, let alone volunteering. Less than 5% of firefighters across the country are female. As your Miss Central New York or Miss Syracuse, I will increase those numbers by sharing my experiences and benefits of being a volunteer firefighter. I am a lifeguard, dance teacher, first-time college student, volunteer firefighter, and I'm a woman. I am here to change the world. I'm excited about getting our young people more involved in our communities. Let's get fired up and volunteer.
Thank you so much, Lillian. Now, I have to tell you that some of them have come from pretty far away, yeah? So, we'll start with you. You guys are all recent, right? How exciting. Just go ahead and introduce yourself.
Hi, everyone. My name is Heather Lawrence. I'm your new Miss Pride of New York's Outstanding Team 2022. I keep thinking it's 2023. Don't ask, long story. My social impact initiative is SPA, Special People's Awareness.
Hello everyone, my name is Nadia Amor. I am your Miss Empire State's Outstanding Team 2022. My social impact initiative is It's Time For You To Shine, promoting support and involvement of arts programs in schools, and I come from Staten Island. Long road trip.
Hi, my name is Marley Thompson, and my social impact initiative is Quality Education Access, and I am from Ithaca.
Hi everybody, my name is Gianna Catano. I am Miss New York's Outstanding Teen. My social impact initiative is CASE, Concussion Awareness Solutions and Education, and I'm from Buffalo, New York.
Hi everyone, my name is Chelsea Lavelle. I'm Miss Finger Lakes 2022. I'm originally from New York City, but I came here from Elmira, New York. My social impact initiative is Celebration of African American Women.
My name is Madeline Teal. I am Miss Niagara 2022, and my social impact initiative is called the Ruby Slipper Project, which is a female empowerment-based program from the Wizard of Oz. So, I'm super excited to be here. I'm from Niagara Falls. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Amy Ryan Austin. I'm Miss Heart of New York's Outstanding Teen 2022. I don't have a contest yet, but I'm still an outstanding teen. And my social impact initiative is You Are Enough Bullying and Suicide Prevention.
Thank you so much, ladies. Another round of applause for these fabulous queens. Thank you for coming from all over to support us today. We really appreciate it. And keep making a positive impact on your communities. Thank you. Have a seat.
I just wanted to quickly add that Syracuse and Central New York will be having a teen representative. Woo! but we haven't selected her just yet. So if you know any teens in Syracuse and Central New York who you believe might be a great representation to our community and our state, send them my way. I think we're nearing the end. I see our sashes are starting to peel from the walls because they're so anxious to get on the bodies of these winners. I still see three, though. This was Syracuse and Central New York. Weirdest thing ever. All right, some more distinguished guests. Thank you so much again, you ladies, for joining us. Make sure you go on to the Vault Selfie Museum at Destiny USA. They're one of our many sponsors that should still be rolling behind my head. But they're not, so go and check them out at Destiny USA. She's got some things over there for you all tomorrow. And you can join us tomorrow at noon when our winners, our two winners, two winners. When our two winners are crowned, you can come and join us tomorrow at noon at Lepore Designs. Say hi, Michael. Our photographer extraordinaire, official photographer for Miss Syracuse and Miss Central New York Scholarship Organization. He took all of these amazing photos that all of you still have yet to see. So the competition is not exactly over. Right, Michael? He's also a proud board member. Thank you so much, Michael, for all your hard work and our media team. Oh, look, it's rolling through. Thank you so much to University United Methodist Church. I know the pastor has gone on to the SU game. And so we will certainly make sure that she gets all of her treats, right? Amazing. Isn't this place amazing? Absolutely amazing. One of the most historic landmarks in Syracuse, which was why it was so important for us to celebrate 100 years right here. All right. Oh, she's not paying attention. I'm just gonna walk on over to her. So I would be remiss if I didn't come and acknowledge the one. She's the one who's responsible for this new and improved Joshua Michael King. Back in tolerant clothes, right?
I'm so proud of you.
I'm proud of you. I'm proud of you. She made it all the way from Auburn today. Ladies and gentlemen, Gwen Weber McLeod from 180. She is one of our many, 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 many proud supportive sponsor, so we are so appreciative to you, Auntie. All right, I think they're ready. I thought enough.
She can find a way. Oh, she can fulfill.
so much, Hannah and 11.
Let's go. You work that out right here. So these women have done an amazing job supporting one another, encouraging one another. We've been speaking to each other every day and all day through a Facebook messenger group, right? Yeah. Executive director will message you at 3, 4, 5 in the morning. Ask the deputy mayor, she knows. But the first award that we'd like to give out is the one that you guys give to yourselves, right? And so the relationships have begun, and I hope that you women will stay connected to each other and, of course, to our organization. But just earlier today, these women voted for Miss Congeniality, and our winner is Scarlett DeWitt. Each of these individual awards are for $250. Wow. So congratulations to you.
Congratulations.
All right, so thank you, Scarlett. It's a lovely gown.
$99, always shop the sale. All
right. Okay, that's how I figure.
Well, my jacket was free. From one of our proud sponsors, Ellie Bala, out of New York City. Our next award is, this one had me up crunching a lot of numbers, and they want to know who was in the lead and how many people were voting for them, and you guys, you, the audience, and you 11 women collectively have raised $4,540. And I'll also add that although we have some amazing sponsors, most of those things were in kind. Mm-hmm. And so you guys actually outraised us. So thank you. With that being said, I guess we probably want to know which one of you is People's Choice. And our People's Choice winner is Victoria Alexandra Wakefield. $1,927. I was gonna come and help you, but you got me out of the way. So just like Scarlett. Just like Scarlett, she'll get a cash prize as well. And we appreciate all of your efforts in helping us fundraise. Thank you. And so, since you guys are still crunching numbers over there, that's okay. I know how to drag it. And I know how to drag it, right? None of y'all get dragged in here tonight. All right, I'm just kidding. I'm not that guy anymore. All right, I think now would be an appropriate time for me to usher back up one of the most important pieces of Miss Syracuse. She is a legacy. She is more than a forever. She's a legacy. And when we were putting this together, we got the opportunity to spend 2 years with this candidate representing Syracuse. Although she lives and works in Buffalo, she traveled down this thruway as though it was only a 10-minute drive. When I needed help, she was there. And when we put this together, it was with her. So ladies and gentlemen, Legacy Mystery. So we have a little something special for you. So come on up here. So they can see you real good for the last time. So Taisha was with us through social crises and a pandemic, and she held it down for this organization and this community. Taisha, thank you.
Anytime, I guess. No, I am not gonna do a real farewell because I'm gonna respect that I resigned my title early, but I will say this. When I had the opportunity to be a part of the executive state team, I took it because I really wanted to help all locals be prepared to handle organizations and do competitions for you ladies. So it's an honor to be here as a forever. And also, I'm so excited for three of you ladies who will be at Miss New York. You will see my face. And thank you, Josh, for everything. So I really appreciate it. A lot of people don't know, Josh judged me. And the minute I was promised Syracuse, like you said, I was in Buffalo, so that was fun. I ended up just starting new appearances, and then he called me, he's like, how are you doing all that? And I just wanted to make an impact, and whoever wins, just know that when you get crowned, your job is to be a public advocate. Your job is to be a public servant, not a celebrity. So that's what I'm saying. Another thing to be prepared for Miss New York is just grow your locals. And that's the only thing I'm gonna say. I'm grateful to be able to be on the stage. Thank you, judges, for donating your time. Thank you, New York State Board. Thank you to the Miss Syracuse and Central New York Board, because this would have been possible without you. And just know, I'm always a phone call away, even at 3 a.m. Thank you.
We did not plan this. We might have.
We did.
So tell everybody once again about yourself and your journey.
So I'm currently a freshman at the University at Buffalo. My major is neuroscience on the pre-med track.
which goes along pretty well with my social impact initiative, which is CASE, Concussion Awareness Solutions and Education. I started CASE because I suffered from a traumatic brain injury my freshman year of high school. So now what I do is I go into elementary schools and educate students on how to keep their heads safe, such as wearing a helmet when riding a bike or playing sports. So that's what I do with my social impact initiative. I competed with the Miss New York organization for 2 years before I won my state title. I was Miss Upstate New York's Outstanding Teen in 2019, and then I was Miss Western New York's Outstanding Teen in 2021. I had the honor of winning Miss New York's Outstanding Teen and competing at Miss America's Outstanding Teen. I'm just so thankful for all this organization has done for me and all the opportunities that it's provided me with.
Well, I unfortunately, you can clap for her. She's actually very, very humble. You left out a bunch of stuff, but don't worry, I'm not gonna hold you to it. I did get a chance to watch from a distance, and I just wanted to make sure that we decorated you since you represent us all. So thank you for your hard work. And best of luck on your journey at school.
Thank you so much.
About time. That one in the middle, she's got an angry face. Gianna, I'm sorry, we were asking you also to stay and be helping us with, wow, with the crown. So we're gonna start by doing the individual category awards so that everybody knows who won each category. And so the winner of evening wear and is Jana Reed. Yeah. And again, this is a $250 cash award. There's some other things in there too. That Julia Walsh is our talent. She won twice at Miss New York for an interview. So, the inaugural Taisha Elizabeth St. Jean Award for a top interview goes to Serena Extent.
Thank you.
tell you, these judges were tough. I made sure they were tough, and I picked them each for a very specific reason. So again, thank you to our judges. Another thing that is super important in the work that we all do is community service. And this particular award relates to your community service, and that award goes to Ashley Dorn. Start where it all started. Malcolm, she done put the tape on the wall, Malcolm. It wasn't me. Let's hear it from Malcolm, the church's. Goodness gracious. So Central New York is a huge catchment. It's a huge responsibility, and we couldn't have picked a better person for this. I just want to make sure this one more time. Okay. The winner of a $1,500 scholarship award and the honor and privilege of representing Miss Central New York is Clara Tyrell. Present and bring back our crown to right here in Syracuse. So I would like also, he's up there in the wings, Charles, give away. And no, you can stay standing. This guy right here, in addition to all of the fundraising that these lovely women have done for months, Charles has truly stepped up in his role as a board member, and when he did need to step away to not be our judge's chair anymore, he was still very close with our organization, and I wish he had a microphone so that he could tell the story himself. However, I'm gonna do my best to describe the sentiments of where this came from. So, of course, I would also be remiss if I didn't acknowledge the stolen lands by which we're standing. Yeah, the stolen tribal lands that we're all standing on. It's a huge responsibility, right? We've talked about this for weeks. We've done Zooms, and we've had many conversations about this. Not everybody was thrilled. But not everybody wrote the check. Charles did. So, with that being said, the third and very prestigious honor really encompasses the story of three sisters. Mm. The squash, the corn, and the beans. And I will probably get more emotional attempting to actually tell the story, so we'll make sure that Charles captures this on our new website full explanation of the story. But I challenged them all to go and look this up, and they did their research and they did their own homework, and they came back with some of the most phenomenal things to say in our groups and in our chats. And so this one's pretty special, I think. And it really completes what it is that we need to happen in order to bring that crown back to Syracuse. So with that, Miss Three Sisters. And also the winner of the $1,500 scholarship, Zonda Reed.
Judges, I thank you.